My favourite thing about Clontarf would be coming in the room, being around a good vibe, being around Luke Burge and Watto and Jakey, just being around all the boys and having a good time.
My most favourite thing about Clontarf is going around, meeting new boys, playing footy with them.
My favourite thing about Clontarf is going away on trips with the boys and having fun, and going training with them.
Getting up with the boys, going on trips, having a bit of a laugh. Favourite thing about Clontarf is probably the hot breakfast.
I don't really have a least favourite, but I don't enjoy waking up early in the morning.
My least favourite thing about Clontarf is getting up early in the morning for training. Don't like it.
About Clontarf is getting up early for training because I live out at Tingo and I have to get up at 5:30 to wait for the boys to pick me up about 6.
My least favourite thing about Clontarf is probably getting up in the morning for training.
My first look at the program was about 4 or 5 years ago when Chris McDonald was up here at Inverell High and I come up here to teach first aid on behalf of TAFE, and I was really, you know, quite overwhelmed with how well the boys were behaved and how much they were getting out of the program. And I guess when I was trying to do a similar type thing down at TAFE with a similar core group of boys, or you just weren't quite getting the results. So I was really drawn to this. I guess it's the biggest part of this is you get the first crack at boys. So down at TAFE we were often the second or third port of call for some of them boys, which I think had a big reason why we couldn't get our end result. And yeah, that's why I was keen to get on board with Clontarf, because I could see that what they were doing was working, and I wanted to be a part of improving young boys' lives. Clontarf's aim is what you would find in their mission statement, where it says that the foundation exists to improve the education, discipline, self-esteem, life skills and employment prospects of young Aboriginal men. And by doing so, this equips them to participate more meaningfully in society. So the aim of the program, in a nutshell, is to get the boys doing the right thing at school and to help them into further education or work, and yeah, to make them be a real part of society. So as far as providing stuff for the boys within the school environment, something that we do on a week-to-week basis is our trainings that we have Tuesday, Thursday mornings, which include us going picking up boys from about 6 o'clock in the morning till 7. Training starts at 7. We run a fun training session for an hour, and then we provide a morning breakfast for the boys every Tuesday, Thursday. So this sort of helps with getting the boys in a routine that they know they have to get themselves out of bed and be ready for the bus. Also, you know, have to be getting to work in time down the track and promoting that healthy lifestyle to start their day. As far as the community side of things goes, we'll try and throw one of them in at least once a week, where we take the boys into the community and try and give back to the community by doing an activity, whether that's helping shoppers at Woolworths or, you know, cleaning the streets or something like that. I guess the main one we like to do is go back to the school, so Inverell Public, Ross Hill and Tinga, where a lot of the boys went to primary school at, and we'll run a coaching clinic there generally once or twice a term, just to give back to them and to show the younger ones out there what Clontarf's all about for when they come up to high school.
We'll go out to schools, do some coaching clinics, like for example we'll go to Tinga or Ross Hill and have a run around with little kids. Well, that was the story of Vincent Lignari, but this is the story of something much more. How power and privilege can unmove a people who know where they stand. We're doing extra activities inside and out of school. We're training the girls, touch girls, and
Union Girls.
On Mondays after school, we go down to Woolworths and help out a fifth around the store.
So as far as helping with the boys' schooling, we don't actually go in class and aid, as some programs do. We offer support where we might go in and settle the boys from time to time, or just do a walk by and check on them. Sometimes it can be one-on-one support, mainly in our room, or we utilise the learning centre up in the library where they've got a couple of girls up there that help the boys out with assignments and that sort of thing. But mainly just keeping an eye on the boys, keep them going to class, keep them on track, letting us know if they got any assignments and that sort of thing, and just trying to make them aware, because a lot of our boys will do the hard yards and get to school, but it's just about getting them once they're here to apply themselves and complete their work.
Hi, so my name's Amy Fenton. I am a learning support teacher at Moonbow High, and I run the learning centre out of our school library, which is a fantastic initiative of our principal, Dr. Holly. I do a lot of work with the Clontarf boys. Probably the most significant part of that is the homework club that we do. So last year we were doing homework club on Thursday mornings, so the boys are actually skipping their footy training and coming to the library at anywhere from 7:15 on cold, frosty winter mornings and actually doing their schoolwork, making on their assignments, making sure they're getting on top of things and getting things in on time. This year we're doing homework club after school. So on Monday afternoons, straight after school, we'll come up here and get working, spend about an hour or so, and then we head down and we actually have an early dinner in the Clontarf room with the boys.
Yes, it does, because just like I said before, the good vibe, they're always there for you, they help you with your schoolwork, and you're never alone, they're always going
to
be there.
Make school more enjoyable, because if you go to school every day and go to training every Tuesdays and Thursdays, you get to go away on trips for top attendance.
Make school more enjoyable, fun, easier.
So we have a few sort of what you would call main events during the year for our boys. Our Year 7 boys, when they first start off, always have an induction camp, which is very early, to try and engage them, to get them to know the Clontarf way and how we roll. So we usually do that week 2 or 3, term 1, take the boys out somewhere local and get around them and show them how things are done. As far as Year 8, 9, 10 go, they'll go to a major tournament, rugby league tournament, which is Ross Kelly Cup in Term 3 in Sydney. So it's a week of activity where we'll go down and practice everything we do throughout the year, not just on the footy field, but with our community visits and partnership visits, and really make a big week of it. And then it sort of all culminates at the end of Year 12 when the boys go away on a major trip. So any boy that completes Year 12 and is a Clontarf boy will go away with all the other Clontarf boys throughout Australia and go on a major trip.
So Clontarf was actually established before I got here. So I walked in and we were already a Clontarf school. I think they'd been Clontarf for a couple of years before I got here. But coming from other schools with lots of Aboriginal students, I can see that it's a program that definitely focuses and makes a difference to young boys' lives.
The boys that started in the program in Year 7 are now in Year 12, and I can see a marked change in not only their attitudes towards school, but also their confidence.
Our retention of Aboriginal students and their attendance rate is fantastic as well.
Seeing Clontarf make an enormous difference in the boys over the years at Inverell High School. There's been a real change often in their personality and wanting to be, things like wanting to be at school, enthusiasm for school. I've seen a dramatic increase in employment of Indigenous boys since the inception of Clontarf.
Engagement within school and engagement with wider school programs is definitely better.
We can now see that we have young men who are prepared to take a positive role in the community, also willing to volunteer, and also their increased sense of willingness to interact with different ages, different generations, people from all different walks of life.
The other thing that I think it actually does is breaks down the barriers as far as community, because our community members are actually happy to come in and talk to the Clontarf boys or have them go and deal with at home, which is something that most schools don't have that opportunity. So getting the parents into our school is far greatly improved with having Clontarf.
Of course, there's a sport aspect, but the biggest difference that I have seen is an increased interaction of young Aboriginal men with all aspects of the local community, and that's a significant positive.
Boys in Year 7 and 8 who weren't great citizens of the school become model citizens of the school, and I credit that to Clontarf.
Clontarf has helped me out heaps during school. It's got me doing assignments and assessments, kept me up to date. We'd go to the library now and then, they'd help us out.
It'd be hard if Clontarf were there, because it'd be hard for me getting to school. And they played a big part in my life, getting me from school. And I haven't helped me out.
If Clontarf wasn't there, I wouldn't attend school as much, because Clontarf always helps me with my schoolwork, getting me to school. Always has, but without it, I wouldn't attend school as much.
Yes, it would be very hard. Like I said, it's like a second home. Everything's here for you. If you need a feed, it's here. They'll help you with their schoolwork, let you get through school, and go on some good trips.